This is the final chapter of the Melody Music Maker Manual, covering the X and Y controllers for the Melody area. Within Melody Music Maker, MIDI data is sent to all MIDI devices present, so that could be multiple apps, Wi-Fi, USB, camera connection kit and all these kind of things. This enables us to, for example, have at the left side the Sunriser app and at the right area the N-Log synthesizers. How to set it up properly? Well, the best is to switch off the chord sound and the melody sound, so they should stand at no sound to free up processor space. In the MIDI settings, a chord channel should be set to 1 and a melody channel to 16. In this case, in the previous manual part, I've set up the Sunriser app with MIDI channel 1. And now I'm going to set up the N-Log synthesizer with MIDI channel 16. Important is that we set the N-Log synthesizer to the same channel as here the melody channel. Then we have here an X controller and a Y controller. The X controller changes the value if your finger is moving in horizontal way. The Y controller is changing its value if your finger is moving in a vertical way. For the X controller, we have now controller 16. It is set up in such a way that at the left side you have a low value and at the right side you have a high value. You can adjust that slightly or even invert it, so that you at the left side have a high value and at the right side have a low value. Well, for this app I would like to have it this way. So, once again, if you're moving horizontal, the X controller will change, and in this case that's controller 16 from low to high. And if you're moving in the vertical direction, you will change the Y controller, and it's in this case controller 17 from low to high. Now switch to the N-Log synthesizer. There we go, loading the N-Log synthesizer. Here I've chosen a certain sound, and in the C step at MIDI, you can set up the MIDI. Here you see the channel is also 16, and controller 16 and 17 are used for the X and the Y. That's important that these data are equal to the data in Melody Music Maker. On the Control tab, you can set which parameter is affected by what changes. So the wheel, I would like to have the oscillator. At the X parameter, I, in my case, would like to have the panning. So if you play at the left, you hear the sound at the left. If you play at the right, you hear the sound at the right. And as a Y parameter, I would like to have a cutoff frequency. So if you play at the bottom, you hear a low cutoff frequency. And if you play at the top side, you hear a high cutoff frequency. Well, that's also it for the N-Log synthesizer. This one is now configured. So let's switch back to the Melody Music Maker. If I now at the Melody Music Maker play in the middle, you hear a neutral sound. Here it's going, this is the cutoff filter. And here you hear the panning, left to right. This enables you to articulate your sound and make it dynamic as you move from right to left. You can move from high to low cutoff frequencies and really articulate your sound by moving your finger. You can freely experiment with this yourself and connect these controllers to whatever kind of parameters. I hope this gives you an inspiration and a good idea of where you can go with Melody Music Maker. If you would like to stay connected to the Melody Music Maker community, please like us on Facebook and you will get kept informed about polls, updates, composing tips and all these kind of things. You can find us on the homepage. Below the trailer movie, you have the like button, so you can there link up with us via Facebook. Or you can find us on Facebook with Melody Music Maker. Well, that's it. I hope you enjoyed it. And let's stay in touch.